the feeling your heart will show you the way. So dance, dance, dance to the music of your passing world. The dream in your eyes and the start of your life are now one.
But I've left something out. There's a house in Moccasin Flats where 14 people live in three small rooms, and it's not unique. This story is not just one of changing one area for another, moving to town from the country. These people pay $65 a month for these old boards. No insulation, only plastic windows in a subarctic winter. Their stove oil costs $25 a month. Firewood, another 25. Drinking water, brought out in a tank truck from town, another 25. A jeep from town to start your car or tow it through the unplowed rutty tracks so the man can get to work, can run another $20-$30 in a real rough winter. And as if that's not bad enough, they're to be evicted. The owner wants the land back.
The dream in your eyes and the start of your life are now one.
Some of them own their own shacks, and maybe, if anyone else would let them use some land, they could put the shacks on skids and move them somewhere else for a while. But for most of Moccasin Flats, until the co-op came along, eviction simply meant going on the road. People of Moccasin Flats, life has taken on a different flavor for them now. It may not be much changed on the surface, but underneath, there's a new current of purpose. It's the purpose that goes with knowing that you're making something for yourself, something to last, something to nourish the future, something to grow on. For 100 years, the white man's world has said to them, you're no good, you don't belong, you can't make it. Now they're standing up and saying, no, that's not true. Look what we're building here, and think again.
Yes, dance, dance, dance to the music of your passing world.
They've seized upon a possibility and made it real.
The dream in your eyes and the start of your life are now one. I see a new day coming, and it's coming very fast. And I wonder if I want this, for I'm haunted by the past. Yes, I wonder if I want this, for I'm haunted by the past.
But the journey across the ridge is not completed yet. The work moves ahead at the co-op, and the families wait to move in. And over the ridge, in the town, still there are people predicting disaster. Somehow, the gulf of history and language and race that divides two groups of people, whose wants and needs and basic attitudes are hardly distinguishable one from the other, persists beyond my understanding. I come into these houses, I hear the talk about the move. I hear a bit of anxiety here and there. Will they be able to make the payments? What if there's a bad year? What if someone should get sick? But mostly what I hear is a quiet confidence, an understanding that they're on to something good, a rich sense of community, of membership in a group that's doing something special, something noteworthy, something the world is going to pay attention to. But as the cards go round, I still wonder about the values that they'll leave behind. Still wonder if their earth and water roots can take hold on the pavement. Is that just my white prejudice at work? Or is the thought in some of their minds, dreaming about their past? And then I think, there really isn't time right now for all that speculation. Winter's on us once again. There are shacks without windows or water, drafty, crowded, and soon to be shut down anyway. The basic challenge has been a decent roof in a decent place, and a decent people has met that challenge, and now there's work to be done.
I'm gonna build me a dream, gonna build it with my heart. There's a voice deep inside me saying, make a brand new start. Make a brand new start. I see a new day coming, and it's coming very fast. And I wondered if I want this, for I'm haunted by the past. Yes, I'm haunted by the past. There's love in my house to keep me satisfied. My dreams can't be shattered by the stormy times of life. Yes, I see a new day coming, it's coming very fast. And I've wondered if I want this, for I'm haunted by the past. I'm building for my children, for I know it's gonna last. But I find myself looking through the window of the past. Through the window of the past. Yes, I see a new day coming, and it's coming very fast. And I wondered if I want this, for I'm haunted by the past. Yes, I'm haunted by the past.
Mortgage payments will cost about $120 a month. The estimated monthly hydro bill is $12 to $15. Gas for the furnace, another $20, $2 to $3 for water. And for many families, the total costs almost equal what they were paying back at the flats. There may be other costs, perhaps not in dollars. These are the people who'll know if it was worth it.